to worship now.
Thank you.
not my fault.
Oh, no.
Worship.
Travel near or far.
Travel near.
Now raise it up. Say, for your glory.
For your glory.
wanna be where you are. Gotta be where you are. Come on, raise it before him, say,
wanna be where you are.
Gotta
be where you are.
I wanna be where.
Wanna be where.
Gotta be where you are. I wanna be where you are. I gotta be where you are. I wanna be where you are. I gotta be there. I really wanna be there. Said I wanna be where. Oh yeah, I gotta be where.
Just don't leave him.
You're my wife. Good morning.
Good morning.
I am Father Robert Solon, and I am the priest of St. John's Episcopal Church, of which the Huntleys have been members, I think, since Christopher Columbus came. It is my privilege and pleasure to be with you today. I am only sad that I have not known probably any of you except for today or a few of you, and I pray God that one day we will be able to meet without these dumb masks. The service of Christian burial from the Book of Common Prayer is excerpted in the handout that you have received, and I ask you to follow along as you wish and as you are able. There are some responses and prayers that you are invited to participate in, and those are in bold. And I also believe that we have then someone who will read the first reading for us as well. I am the resurrection and the life, saith the Lord. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. and whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though this body be destroyed, yet shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and mine eyes shall behold, and not as a stranger. For none of us liveth to himself, and no one dieth to himself. For if we live, we live unto the Lord, and if we die unto the Lord. Whether we live, therefore, or die, we are the Lord's. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Even so saith the Spirit, for they rest from their labors. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. My friends, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. O God, whose mercies cannot be numbered, accept our prayers on behalf of thy servant Michael, and grant him an entrance into the land of light and joy and the fellowship of thy saints, through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
I believe someone has going to read this for us.
After this, I looked, and behold, a great multitude, which no man could number, every nation, from all tribes and peoples and tongues, stand before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed in white robes, with palm branches in their hands, and crying out with a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God, who sits upon the throne, and to the Lamb." And the angels stood round the throne, and round the elders, and the four living creatures, and they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, saying, "Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these clothed in white robes, and whence have they come?" I said to him, "Sir, you know." And he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore are they before the throne of God and serve him day and night within his temple. And he who sits upon the throne will shelter him, shelter them with his presence. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more. The sun shall not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb in the midst of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to spring of living water, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes."
Thank you very much. Amen. Friends, would you say with me Psalm 23? We'll say it together.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest the table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Jesus said, "All that the Father gives me will come to me, and him who comes to me I will not cast out. For I have come down from heaven, not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up at the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him should have eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May we, in the word written and in the word spoken, encounter the very word incarnate. Amen. It's starting to cloud up already this day. It seems like this winter has been more clouds than not. But this morning, if you were out a little bit, there were no clouds and it was bright and sunny. I hope you had the chance to notice that. In the rectory at St. John's, I've turned the third floor room into a bit of a chapel. And I went up this morning to recite morning prayer, as I normally do, and the window faces due east. And this morning, the sun was just over the apartment buildings, I guess they're condos, next to me, and was shining right into the window and right into my eyes. And I was blinded. To the point where when I looked down at the page, you know, I saw the sun. You know, it had temporarily blinded my eye a bit. It was so bright, and yet it was so welcome. I don't know about you, but I've missed the sun. And to wake up and to pray with the morning sun on my face, and not just in my eyes, but blinding me, was a moment with God. I've got to think that is similar to what Michael Hollis Huntley is experiencing as we speak. In the reading from the Revelation to St. John, we get a glimpse of the divine throne room. Now, I think all of you are younger than me, because I'm only 27, and I can clearly see that all of you are yes. And I do know that Trinidad and Tobago was at one point part of the British Empire. And some of you will have, perhaps, an affection for Her Majesty the Queen. Perhaps you don't, because right now Trinidad and Tobago is a republic, and there's a president. But I have found that people who have a British background of some kind do royalty better than than native United States citizens do. There's something that we just don't get that many other people get. And and I'm absolutely fascinated whenever I get to watch anything on TV, like the state opening of Parliament, or a royal wedding, or anything that has to do with the royal family, because it's beautiful. Everyone knows exactly what they're doing. They're dressed in their absolute finest. And particularly when you see the Queen and on the state throne at the beginning of Parliament, it's an impressive sight. Nothing compared to what the divine throne room is. Nothing. We get a glimpse of it today with the angels and the archangels and the myriads and myriads of people clothed in white robes. And I gotta think that it's so impressive that it's like blinding. Like the sun blinded me this morning. I gotta think that when you're there, it's blinding to your soul. Because you can't see the glory of God. Exactly. Now, I understand that Michael was clearly an aficionado of Calypso. And as I said, you're my choir, so you got something to do here in a bit. I don't know if he would have been impressed with the divine throne room with, you know, thrones and angels and archangels and all that. I don't know, maybe. I, alas, and unfortunately, and with some anger, have not and will not know him in this life. I wish I had. But I wonder if when he knocked on those pearly gates. If instead of harps and, you know, little floaty angels and whatnot, I wonder if there was a big street parade and the Calypso band. And people in masks and gold and silver, like Carnival, which I understand was his favorite time of the year. I gotta think that when Peter looked at his list and said, "Come on in, Hollis," then the gates flung open, and they threw Carnival just for him. I gotta think that. And so what I want you to know, my friends, is that however heaven really is, and St. John had his vision of it, perhaps Hollis has his vision of it, and I hope it's okay at least today that I can call him by that name. Thank you. That heaven, whatever it is blinding to our souls, and we can never get all of it in view, but whatever it is the place of joy, it is the place of light, it is the place where God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. And it is the place where, although I know Michael was at home and suffering for weeks, that he is now not suffering. That he is there dancing down that street with Calypso music. And I don't know if he had a favorite costume or if he ever did that, but you can imagine he's there doing that. And that God takes delight in that and in him. So that's the first thing. His suffering, my friends, is over, and thanks be to God for that. The second thing that I would encourage you to do, and it is so easy in this day and age to not do it, is after today, but don't wait too long to do this, look on your calendars and pick a day. Maybe it's January 19th of next year. Maybe it's January 14th of next year. Maybe it's his birthday of next year. Or maybe it's Monday or Tuesday before Ash Wednesday next year during Carnival. Pick a day. Get together. God willing, you'll be able to do that without masks and without social distancing. And remember Michael, who was husband and father and grandfather, and I think aunt and or uncle rather, and great uncle, and who knows all what else, and friend, and invite everyone you know, and maybe we'll, God willing, we can have a memorial service at the church. We, you know, whatever we want to do, whatever you want to do, but remember Michael, because although he is in heaven, and yes, he looks at us and sees us right now. He's got better things going on right now, and we're still here, but we can remember him and should. So do that. I encourage you to do that and set aside a specific time to do that. And the third thing, my friends, is simply this. I know that his family, some of you are here, some are in England, I believe. Also in Trinidad and Tobago as we speak, and I understand that by miracle of technology, my words are reaching them even today, and how humbling that is. And so I speak to all of you, not just here, but around the world, when I say this. My friends, God has big shoulders. It doesn't matter what you're feeling right now. Well, it does, because God welcomes all of your feelings. You may be sad. You may be angry. You may feel relieved. You may feel guilty that you're feeling relieved. Whatever, you may feel joy. And you may feel all of those and none of those in the days and weeks ahead, like going up and down, like a roller coaster. God created us in his own image with emotions. And our Lord himself wept at the grave of Lazarus, his friend. Jesus, who was a fully human, one of us, blesses all our human emotions. The Jesus who is the Son of God and Son of Man, who is a real human being, who came to earth not to do his will, but the will of him who sent him, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him should have eternal life. That same Jesus, whom Michael clearly worshipped, adored, and was friends with, says to us, it's okay. God our Father has big shoulders and can take whatever it is we have to give him. So in these next days and weeks, give him your joy, give him your grief, give him your sorrow, and your anger, and your relief, and your guilt, and whatever it is that you've got, knowing full well that even now, our Lord's loving arms are around each of you, consoling you, and saying, yes, I know. Because God in Christ does know. And even though the angels and the archangels are flitting around the throne with their harps, or maybe in the Calypso room, they're doing whatever, I don't know, whatever carnival dances there are. I don't know what those are, but I imagine they're fun. I'm a white guy, so I'm sure I could do it anyway. Because remember, God, heaven has many rooms, many mansions. So there's got to be a Calypso room, probably a whole Calypso, hall. Know that God embraces each of us. Remember Hollis at a specific time in the next year. And know that even right now, whatever God's throne looks like, whatever God looks like, he is right there. With God, no suffering, no pain, no tears, but joy and reverence and expectation that all of us, and especially his family, will one day be there with him. Let our prayers and thanksgivings for Michael Hollis Huntley rise to the throne, rise to that throne room, be carried up on steel drums to God our Father in our Lord Jesus Christ, who came to us as a human being and even now wants us to be with God through him. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My friends, in the sure and certain faith that Michael had, let us reaffirm our faith as we say together the Apostles' Creed on the top of the next page of the bulletin. I believe in God, the Father of the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And as our own Savior Christ has taught us, we pray together, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, the glory forever and ever. Amen.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer.
Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, who has knit together thine elect in one communion and fellowship, in the mystical body of thy Son, Christ our Lord, grant, we beseech thee, to thy whole church, in paradise and on earth, thy light and thy peace.
Lord, have mercy, hear our prayer.
Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to newness of life, and that through the grave and gate of death, we may pass with him to our joyful resurrection.
Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer.
Grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage, and who walk as yet by faith, that thy Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days.
Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer.
Grant to thy faithful people pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve thee with a quiet mind.
Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer.
Grant to all who mourn a sure confidence in thy fatherly care, that casting all their grief on thee, they may know the consolation of thy love.
Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer.
Give courage and faith to those who are bereaved, that they may have strength to meet the days ahead in the comfort of a reasonable and holy hope, in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love.
Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer.
Help us, we pray, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting.
Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer.
Grant us grace to entrust Michael to thy never-failing love. Receive him into the arms of thy mercy, and remember him according to the favor which thou bearest unto thy people.
Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer.
Grant that, increasing in knowledge and love of thee, he may go from strength to strength in the life of perfect service in thy heavenly kingdom.
Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer.
Grant us, with all who have died in the hope of the resurrection, to have our consummation and bliss in thy eternal and everlasting glory, and with the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. John the Evangelist, and all thy saints, to receive the crown of life which thou dost promise to all who share in the victory of thy Son, Jesus Christ, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Give rest, O Christ, to thy servant with thy saints.
May sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing but everlasting.
Thou only art immortal, the creator and maker of mankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and unto earth shall we return. For so thou didst ordain when thou createdst me, saying, dust thou art, and unto dust shalt thou return. All we go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
Give rest, O Christ, to thy servant with thy saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing but life everlasting.
Into thy hands, O merciful Savior, we commend thy servant Michael. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech thee, a sheep of thine own fold, a lamb of thine own flock, a sinner of thine own redeeming. Receive him into thy mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light.
Amen.
Cemetery. So I believe that there will be instructions from the funeral directors. Mm-hmm. I will send you there.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, we'll accept. Oh, okay. Thank you. Yeah, I'm already, you know, I'm already, Thank you. Yes, we can end up on the side and help us in the back. We can go this way and go around.
We need a few guys to help us with the test, okay?
In the back. You can go outside. We need to go back. Come on, you're right. Yeah, we have to, she has to go with me, so you guys start packing up.
No, he's gonna
what? The video going out?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, is that okay with you?
Yeah, it's okay.
And we're gonna take the, we're gonna get the blanket thing.
I'm not sure. You can get up here early.